بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ بَارِئِ الْخَلَائِقِ أَجْمَعِينَ بَاعِثِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَالْمُرْسَلِينَ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا سَيِّدِ النَّبِيِّينَ الذي سمي في اللاهوت بأحمد وفي الناسوت بأبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الهداة المهديين المعصومين المنتجبين واللعن الدائم على أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى يوم الدين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In last presentation, we mentioned that there are two approaches to religion, no matter what, Islam or Christianity or Jewish or other religion. And since the beginning of Islam, has been evident, and we've seen these two approaches by the peoples. They were coming inside Islam and they accepted Islam. Some of early people were coming to Islam by the reason of its spirituality only. Its morality, its spirituality. They had found what they had been missing. They had found the answer of the question that was inside their nature. They had recognized that the Islamic thought are the best way to access the reality. They had recognized what had been revealed to Holy Prophet, and they were hearing from the tongue of him as the medicine for illness inside their hearts. In Holy Quran, regarding this group says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين. سورة يونس number 57. O people, an admonition has now come to you from your Lord, and a healing for what is in the chest, a guide and a mercy to believer. They were considering what they were hearing from the Prophet's tongue as the message has come from their heart. The message has come for their hearts and directly was coming inside their heart. Their heart accepting these messages from the Holy Quran. Seems to me that the majority of people of Medina who they embraced Islam when the Prophet was in Mecca, that time was living in Mecca, and he had not yet come to Medina. They embrace Islam before coming, before immigration to Medina, that time. Seems to me that the majority of them were from this group. Because the spirituality of Islam, spirituality of Quran, morality of Quran, morality of Islamic thoughts attracted them. The historian like Tabari, Abu Ishaq, Ibn Hisham, all of them narrating this history that I am going to quote for you, a hadith. This story is the cause of the immigration. It ends to the immigration of Prophet, this story that I am going to say for you. I translate the text of Tabari. Before coming our Prophet to Medina, the name of Medina was Yathrib, you know. Medina is the name that our Prophet has named that place, Medina to Nabi. Medina is a place, is civilized place, because coming of Prophet, of our Prophet, that place was not any civilization there. Its name was Yathrib, and two tribes were living there, and all the years, were fighting with each other. And I have seen in some history, books of historian people, historian writers, that there was a stream of water. All of that water was the blood, because the fighting and killing everybody each other. Killing each other. All the time during the year. Only some months, they named Ashhur al-Hurum. That fight was forbidden only for gathering and collecting the weapons, and preparing the weapons for the fighting for the future. Only some months, 3 months, Ashhur al-Hurum. When the Prophet Holy Prophet, had started his invitation, a delegation of one of two tribes had gone from Yathrib to Mecca. For what? To request the tribe of Quraysh to protect them by submitting some weapons to them. A delegation from Medina, from Yathrib, traveled to Mecca to request request the tribe of Quraysh to gain the weapons for them, for themselves. When they arrived the city of Mecca, straightly went to the house of the head of the tribe. I mean, Shaybah and Utbah. These two persons were the up of the tribes. They came inside their home and sat down. When the delegation put on the desk their suggestion and they asked and negotiated, started to negotiate that you should help us by the weapon or something, immediately they rejected. No, 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 no. This year we cannot help anybody. This year we cannot help you. Why? They answered, because this year we are engaged. Because a young man has arisen and he is deceiving our young. And we are engaged. We have no time. We are very busy. We are offending from our gods. And he is deceiving our young, attacking to our gods and to our idols. So we are very, very engaged. So we cannot help you. They asked, by what? What's they? He can deceive your young. They told, they answered, by reading some sentences, some text. And all the youngs, they are attracting to him. And they all young go to him and follow him. They became persuaded, so, and stood up to leave them. When they were going to depart Quraysh home, asked the Quraysh people, the two persons, Utbah and Shaybah, asked, where are you going to just already? They answered, we are going to, first, we are going to take tawaf and do tawaf, so going back to our home. They told, no, 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 don't go inside the masjid. We are afraid for you. Why? Because the young man that we told for you, that we told you, that he has arisen and he are opposing our gods. He is sitting inside masjid. And if you go there, we are afraid that you hear what he is reciting and what he is reading. And we are afraid for you, that you as well be under his influence. Our suggestion is that you go straightly to your home. They answered, it is not possible. It is not possible for us. We have come from Medina to Mecca, from Yathrib to Mecca. Nobody can come inside Mecca and without tawaf leave Mecca. We should take tawaf. We should get tawaf. and ask them, what is the way? What is your suggestion? They told that we have one suggestion to you, for you. What is that? Our suggestion is that you put something like cotton in your eyes. When you are rounding around the Kaaba, your ear don't hear the voice of him. They accepted. That's a good idea. They told us a good idea. They accepted this. And put some cotton in their eyes and went inside the masjid. They arrived in masjid and they started to round around about the Kaaba and around the Kaaba. Suddenly one of them addressed to the others, "Oh my friend, why don't we hear the voice? If it was good, we accept. And it was not good, we don't accept. We can judge ourselves. We have a reason. It is not good way that we don't hear the voice." Don't hear the voice that we say, afraid that perhaps he can deceive us. It is not good. It's not good argument. His friend accepted his suggestion. And they took all the cotton out, got out from their eyes. When they finished their tawaf, suddenly they looked to the young man that was sitting inside Hajr al-Ismail. Hajr al-Ismail. They went to him. Tabari has written, they asked, "Oh Muhammad, what is your suggestion to us? To what you are inviting us? What do you inviting to? And what do you want from us? And what is your suggestion to us? If you are inviting us to Islam, what is your manifest? What is your program for us?" Holy Prophet, he started to recite some verses at the end of the Surah Al-Furqan. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما إلى آخر السورة. They were thinking. Suddenly one of them told to others, "Oh friends, this is our medicine for our pains. We are fighting with each other all the years. We can live under this thought, under these teachings, brotherly and reconcile with each other and friendship. We can live with peace. Under the peace. And he did became Muslim and requested the Holy Prophet to envoy a delegation or a man representative of himself to recite these verses to the people of our city. Then the Holy Prophet sent the Mus'ab ibn Umair to Medina to recite the Holy Quran for the people of Medina. Tabari has written, when Mus'ab ibn Umair came to Medina, he stood up near a place of water, wheel, and the people were coming there and getting the water from that wheel. He stood up there and reciting the Quran. Group after group, they became Muslim. And they invited the Holy Prophet to immigrate to Medina. They became Muslim before coming our Prophet, before establishing the government of Islamic government, before having any power. So these people, attracted by the morality of Islam, spirituality of Islam, not for money, not for power, not for anything else. If this group in their lives become a powerful man, with these ideas, they never sacrificed the religion in the way of the power. They don't consider the religion as an instrument for power, like Yazid bin Muawiyah, like Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan. These people never sacrificed the religion and the religious thoughts, religious teachings in the way of the power. For example, Salman, last session, I referred to his name. He was Iranian, but he had come to Mecca to find the Holy Prophet. When he came, a wali, guardian of the province of Kufa and Mada'in. He was a spiritual man. He didn't gather any money. Everything was in his hand, but he didn't gather any money, any per party. He didn't kill anybody. He didn't bother anybody. All the people were loving him, because he was a moral man. They are following of Prophet. The Prophet himself was like this. The Prophet himself, when he became a powerful man, he didn't change anything. He didn't change. He didn't. He was a man. Quran says, "Innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim." It means that you are with a high ethics. Innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim. Your morality and your conduct is ethical and moral. And if you don't have this moral, if you don't have this conduct, all the people reject you and live and will leave you. This in Holy Quran says. Tabari has written another hadith. Ibn Hisham as well. Both of them have quoted this hadith. In a war, I'm hesitating. It was the war of Khaybar or another one. Perhaps it was Khaybar, because Tabari doesn't name the name of that war. He was surrounded the place of the enemy, and he couldn't go inside. The army couldn't go inside because the wall was very high. And one of the army, after 3 months, they couldn't go inside. One Muslim came to Prophet, said, "I have a suggestion, good suggestion for you, that you reach to victory." What suggestion? That at the outside, at the behind of this place, the drink water for these people inside this place comes from one spring outside of the behind of this place. We can poison that. We can poison that, and all the people inside passed away. But we were a victory. We reached to the victory. Because all the enemy will pass. Prophet says, no. Because inside the people, these people are the children, are the women. They are not soldiers. We are fighting in the way of God. We want to invite them to Islam. They attack to us. We are offensive. We are defending from ourselves. But we cannot poison the water and kill the children, kill the women. And so he said a sentence. This sentence is the source of all fuqaha fatwa. He declared, Prophet declared, it is forbidden to poison the water of enemy, any enemy, no matter what, mushrik or other one. It is not the way of fighting. If you poison the water, drink water, the children and women are under the danger and threat them, you should not. It is forbidden for for any Muslim to poison the drink water of enemies. And this is the fatwa of all fuqaha of Islam. Anyway, Prophet himself, when he became powerful man, he didn't quit the morality and ethics, the mercy and friendship and hospitality and anything and morality. But a group, the second group, they have come to religion only by the power, and they are looking to religion an instrument of power. They kill the other under the name of religion. They steal the money of each other under the name of religion and justified by the religion, unfortunately. Excuse me, the time is off and I should finish my talking. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammadin wa ajjil farajahum. Allahumma arzuqna tawfiq al-ta'ah wa bu'd al-ma'siyah wa sidq al-niyyah wa irfan al-hurmah wa saddid al-sanatana bil-sawab wal-hikmah wa amla' qulubana bil-ilm wal-ma'rifah wa tafadhal ala ulama'ina bil-zuhd wal-nasihah وعلى أمرائنا بالعدل والشفقة وعلى المتعلمين بالجهد والطاقة وعلى التجار بالإنصاف وحسن السيرة اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد رحم الله من قرأ الفاتحة مع الصلوات